Hello everyone, this is Donnie, aka Elevated, with another video on behalf of Dota Alchemy, and thank you again for tuning in today. This one is going to be a bit of a simple video, I must apologize. The replays are all bugged from the Dream League Major, and that means that I can't really splice in any awesome content of pros playing these heroes. But if you haven't guessed it already, we're going to be talking about tier lists again. We've got a new patch, we've got a new meta, and we have a new set of qualifiers to pull data from, so we're going to be looking at some of the best heroes in each of the roles over the next few days here on this channel. Starting with the hard supports, you may recognize some of these heroes from the past because some of them are still really damn good, but there's quite a few newcomers to the list as well, so it's about time that we updated the tier list, and let's hop right into it. Starting with the S tier, we have Crystal Maiden. CM is kind of the quintessential support right now. She gives her entire team mana, she gives her entire team magic resistance as of patch 7.23. She can farm neutrals when she needs to, she can stack neutrals and farm them with Freezing Field, and she's a pretty good laner as well. She empowers her team to fight all over the map and has one of the better talent trees in the entire game, which benefits very heavily from the current meta, where she's gonna naturally get a bit of extra experience and gold through just simply the nature of Dota, with the outposts and the neutral camps being highly prioritized at the moment. Crystal Maiden has been tweaked a little bit of nerfs in the last couple of patches, but at the same time, she still does everything you really want out of a position 5 support. She team fights well, she has control, she lanes pretty well, and she just provides a huge amount of value from not a whole lot of farm requirement, but also scales very, very well if she does get the right items too. So that's CM. She's still an S tier hero, and we're seeing a lot of pros pick her up. Vengeful Spirit is a relative newcomer to the higher echelons of support picks, but it's something that has been on the rise for a while. It was definitely extremely good last patch and probably overlooked a little bit, and now it is absolutely one of the best support heroes in the entire game, both as a 5 and as a 4 and an offlaner, and sometimes even as a carry. The Vengeance aura changes, where it now gives primary attribute as if it was Luna, is a big, big buff to Vengeful Spirit. You know, it used to give damage, but now it just gives raw stats, which most people would kind of prefer, especially in the early game. And since we're trending towards this early fighting, almost death ball-y style of meta, Venge fits right into that very well. In addition to that, the hero had been buffed for several patches before 7.22, even 7.23, and so Magic Missile costs less, she's very good at trading, she naturally has an incredibly solid body where stat gain is very high, armor is very high, and it just fits super well into what you want out of a 5, somebody who can run in, somebody who can sacrifice themselves for the team, but also make it very difficult for the enemy team to kill you. So they have to invest a lot of resources taking out a 5 who's happy to trade their life in exchange for an enemy core. Vengeful Spirit is one of the highest win rate heroes in the entire game right now, and I think a lot of that probably comes from the fact that the Vengeance illusion that you get when you die is just basically like a zero downtime hero. So even when you die, you're still there, you're still providing your aura, and while you might not be able to cast spells until you have an Aghanim Scepter, if you have something like a Vladimir's Offering, if you have a Helm of Dominator, or any other good aura, you're still providing that to your team, and you can also right-click people and provide vision and just all sorts of extra utility that no other support provides when they're dead, which is pretty cool. So no surprise that Venge has made it up to the S tier now. The next hero on our list is Nature's Prophet, and this hero has leaped from sort of unplayable to one of the best heroes in the game as a 5, simply because he has the ability to snipe couriers. Now that everybody has a courier and they are incredibly slow, so now that the couriers are tied to the passive gold gain of players, sniping them means that you are denying them a huge amount of gold in addition to the items that they might be trying to ferry themselves. Nature's Prophet is the only hero in the game. Trust me, I've tried a couple other heroes, Bounty Hunter, Monkey King, and some other roamers, and it just doesn't quite work because you don't get enough experience, you can't help your lanes out enough, but Nature's Prophet can essentially be in two places at once because of teleport, and you can double it up with a TP scroll, so you can go snipe a courier, place a ward so you can snipe more couriers, TP back to your lane, help your carry out for a little bit until teleport is back off of cooldown, go snipe some more couriers, come back to lane. It's a very, very easy way to just heavily impact all of the lanes potentially from the position 5 while also supporting your core in the lane that you're supposed to be in. In addition to that, we now have extra objectives on opposite sides of the map, so Nature's Prophet can teleport right into the outposts and help claim them. Doesn't have to deal with the longer teleport that outposts make you channel normally on a TP scroll. There's bounty runes that are much more separated than they used to be, and it just feels like there's so much more map to cover, so having a global teleport spell on a pretty short cooldown is just inherently very, very strong. And now that heroes are getting so many extra items, even the fives tend to get pretty farmed. Nature's Prophet is obviously one of those heroes that benefits from having a lot of extra farm, so if you're able to find something like a Philosopher's Stone, then the Prophet can essentially turn into a core as the game progresses as well, and when you have a 5 that's also a core, you're looking pretty darn good at winning the game. The final hero in the S tier is Keeper of the Light. Obviously, this hero was the bane of everybody's existence last patch. They nerfed the cast range on both Blinding Light and his ultimate. They increased the mana cost of Blinding Light, and they also nerfed his cast range talents. However, he's still extremely good, he's still extremely viable, and I would highly recommend continuing to pick Keeper of the Light until they nerf him further. And here's why. Now you don't have to buy couriers. Now you don't have to buy wards. They don't cost anything, which means that even though you get one less Blinding Light at level 1, you can start with 3 mangoes and go to the lane, which means that you can cast an additional Blinding Light in the laning stage until you get to Chakra Magic, and by the time you're level 2, level 3, the hero is essentially the exact same as it was previously. Sure, the cast range is a little bit of a bigger deal because it's harder to, you know, blast people back into your tower. Means that you can't trade quite as well as you could previously, but he's also one of the fastest heroes in the entire game, and that pretty much makes up for not having quite as long of a cast range on his skills. So now I just want to quickly go over all of the A tier heroes, and if you have any questions about the B or C tier, go ahead and throw those in the comment section below. I will read them and I'll try to respond to as many as possible. But let's go ahead and jump into Snapfire, our first A tier hero. One of the most fun heroes that's been introduced to the game in a while. Her ultimate is super cool, but that's not why she's such a good 5. The reason that she's such a good 5 is Little Shredder. 75 mana for an unbelievable amount of damage. She is potentially the best trader in the entire game at level 1. In fact, I don't think there is a better hero, because not only do you slow people's attack speed, but it just does too much damage. So you can take excellent trades with this hero and bully people out of your lane, and then the rest of her skills work pretty well for a 5 as well. You've got a little bit of a repositioning, you've got a stun, you got a slow. You have setup for your carry to get kills in the lane or potentially to save them. And then when it comes to mid and late game team fights, this hero just does way too much damage. Mortimer's Kisses is, it's like a macro pyre each one, and you get 8 every single ultimate. So they gave her way too much damage. And if you pair it with something like a Faceless Void or anybody else who holds heroes in place, you are essentially just automatically winning team fights if you get off an entire ultimate on Snapfire. Bane has been very heavily buffed. Anytime that Ice Frog decides to combine skills, now you have Enfeeble on every other cast of your spells, which means that you don't have to bother enfeebling people to then get the extra status resistance reduction, the magic reduction. It just happens. All you have to do is brain sap somebody, and boom, suddenly they're being disabled for extra time. So that in and of itself would be enough, but again, we're kind of trending towards this meta where heroes want to fight constantly, and Bane is one of the best fighters in the early game. Super, super good at securing these objectives. They've buffed his entire kit with the Enfeeble, and also just across the board, he's gotten quite a few buffs to his skills over the last few patches. Also, This is a hero who does not farm. Literally cannot farm creeps at all. And now he gets neutral items that his cores will give him when they don't fit the core's build. So he just is one of those heroes that benefits so much from 723 because his net worth will just increase by existing, and he's going to be able to help his cores have good games, which will allow them to farm items for him to use. Silencer has finally made a trip to the A tier, and this has always been one of those hub heroes that you really, really hate to play against as an offlaner. The Glaives of Wisdom does so much damage, and now he's kind of like a mini Outworld Devourer. It steals Int, which means he does extra damage, he takes away your mana, and it also boosts his last word nuke damage as well. So Silencer just does way more damage now, and he already did a ton of damage in the laning stage. So this hero is just a lot stronger early on. Again, a hero who loves fighting, a hero who doesn't farm very well, but will benefit from a huge amount of extra farm being given to him from the neutral drops, and has the game-changing ultimate that you'd always like your five to have. Ogre Magi, he's always going to be a good support. There's just nothing that you really dislike about his kit. He's very beefy in the lane. He can bully people out, give your carry a bunch of space, and then give your carry bloodlust as the game goes on. He loves to fight. He's got a GPM talent, actually has an incredibly good talent tree, which, as we've talked about before, benefits from the extra experience that's flying around through the outposts, and is another hero that doesn't really farm very well on his own, but would love to have a few extra items that his carries farm for him using the bloodlust. Jakiro has been called the ranged Ogre Magi, so it makes sense that he's in the same tier as the previous hero. They both have two heads, they're both very tanky, they both do a ton of magic damage and control in team fights. So Jakiro is one of my favorite heroes currently to pick as a position 5. He allows you to push towers, he allows you to de-push waves, he can set up from long distance to stop a pesky Crystal Maiden ultimate, for example, or a TP that most heroes wouldn't be able to get in range with. And then he's got one of the better talent trees as well. Tons of damage, tons of utility, and an EXP talent that benefits very heavily from the outposts. Warlock makes the list, mostly just because of his talent tree, one of the best talent trees in the entire game. You know, the current meta doesn't really favor long cooldowns, but at the same time, how can you say no to a hero that has a 50% EXP gain when heroes are getting so much extra EXP from the outpost? In addition to that, if you can somehow get to level 30 on this hero, your golems literally become the strongest units on the entire map, even against a late game carry. If you can get Aghanim's Refresher, you suddenly have 4, even 5 golems if you die that are 100% magic resistant, 25 armor on top of that, and will just absolutely carry the game at that point. So while the hero is not necessarily the best at fighting constantly, when you do take fights, they will be high impact, and he fits pretty well into the current meta, which is very aggressive in the laning stage. So if you want to run a more greedy core like an Alchemist or a Slark, Anti-Mage, Spectre, or something like that, if you just have the Warlock sitting behind them, throwing the Shadow Word on that hero over and over in the laning stage, chances are you can probably out-sustain some of these very high harass lanes. And our final A-tier hero is Shadow Demon. He's kind of been on this list in the past and slipped down a little bit now, but with the addition of all the neutral camps, with the ability that Shadow Demon has to stack them and clear them on his own, plus a very high EXP talent at level 10 and a very, very good talent tree all the way through, there's nothing that you really don't like about this guy's kit. So that's our hard support tier list. I guarantee if you're picking these S or A tier heroes, if a couple of them speak to you, if you like playing those heroes, even if you're picking the B or C tier, you're going to probably have some success. The support role right now is in a pretty good spot. It's pretty fun when you have all this extra farm, all these extra items, all this extra experience. Your impact feels higher than it probably ever has before. And that means that being a support right now is a pretty fun prospect in the game of Dota 2. So let me know what you think of this video. Let me know what you think of this tier list. And stay tuned for the following tier lists on the other positions coming out in the next couple of days. Good luck, have fun in your games, and we'll see you in another video.